Outside of that, use quality oils, keep up with maintenance, and do all of the basics, and the VQ37 can live a very reliable life to 200,000 plus miles. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the most common Nissan VQ37 VHR engine problems. The VQ37 engine was used from 2008 until 2020 in a number of different Nissan and Infiniti models. Of course, it's most notably known for its use in the Infiniti G37 and the Nissan 370Z. The high-revving 3.7 liter V6 engine produces up to 350 horsepower and 276 foot-pounds of torque. The VQ37 VHR also delivers very good reliability, which means the VQ37 delivers a great overall balance of performance, reliability, efficiency, and fun. However, no engine is perfect and there aren't any exceptions here. The VQ37 is still prone to a number of issues. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss the most common problems with this engine. Starting off with the first issue at hand, one of the most common issues with the Nissan VQ37 engine is oil galley gasket failure. The VQ37 has two oil galleys behind the timing chain cover, and these galleys are responsible for flowing oil to the timing chain. Now, there are two gaskets in these oil galleys responsible for sealing that timing chain cover to the engine block, and both of these gaskets are prone to failing on this engine. Before diving into the bulk of this issue, I do want to point out that Nissan did fix this issue sometime in 2012. The exact dates when this problem were fixed aren't known, but for the most part, any 2013 plus models are more or less exempt from this problem. Issues can still happen, but it was predominantly an issue on those 2012 and older models. Now, if and when the oil galley gaskets fail, it can lead to a very sudden and rapid loss of oil pressure, which can be a serious issue that could cause additional damage. So if you run into this failure and notice that you have a low oil pressure light popping up, it's important to pull over in a safe location as soon as possible to protect the engine from suffering any potential further damage. So just something to keep in mind with this issue. And also the most important reason of discussing this problem as being a common issue, not only because it is a rather common issue on these earlier engines, but it's also a very expensive and costly repair. The gaskets are relatively cheap, I believe under about $50 to $75 for both of the gaskets. However, it's an incredibly labor-intensive job, so if you find yourself going to a repair shop to replace these oil galley gaskets, you could very likely end up with a repair bill in the ballpark of about $1,200 to $2,500, so it can be a very serious issue. And if you do run into failure of one of these gaskets, there really isn't an option other than to replace it, so that is going to be an expensive repair bill if you aren't DIYing the job. Now again, Nissan did update these gaskets, and so when you buy the updated gaskets, they have a very low failure rate and are very unlikely to fail again. So fortunately, it's just a one-time thing and not an issue that keeps popping up every 50 to 75,000 miles. Moving on to the second most common problem, we have catalytic converter failure. Now, it's pretty common for the catalytic converter, especially on the passenger side, to actually become clogged and fail over time on this engine. Catalytic converters, of course, are very expensive, so this is another thing to be on the lookout for and consider. There's also not a certain cutoff here, but it does seem to be a more common issue on older VQ37 engines. And that could just be an age-related thing, or it's possible the newer parts were updated at some point and less prone to failure. Some of the most common symptoms associated with catalytic converter failure on this engine include the check engine light, rough idle, exhaust rattle, poor performance, among a couple other little things. So if you're noticing any of these symptoms, it's very possible that you've run into catalytic converter failure. And depending on the extent of it, the symptoms can be more or less severe, or there could be a couple additional symptoms on top of that. But a lot of the times when it triggers that check engine light, you'll be able to read the associated fault codes and detect a potential issue with the catalytic converters. So ultimately, as a final note, this isn't a terribly common issue. It's just something to consider since it can be a relatively costly job to replace a catalytic converter. And so a lot of the times you may want to consider going for aftermarket exhaust and replacing the factory catalytic converters with high flow cats. A lot of the times that can be a cheaper repair in the long term. Moving on to the third and final common problem, we have high oil consumption. Much like its older brother, the Nissan VQ35 engine, the VQ37 is also prone to excessive oil consumption. Fortunately, this isn't usually a serious issue in the grand scheme, and this hasn't been traced back to one specific issue or design flaw. High oil consumption also becomes more common on older, higher mileage engines just due to some natural wear and tear. But some of these engines do just tend to naturally consume more oil than your average engine, and a lot of the times it doesn't affect overall reliability or longevity. It's just something to be aware of and something that's important to understand, especially if you're noticing high oil consumption on your VQ37. Carry some extra oil around, have some extra oil at home, since obviously running the engine low on oil for the long term can cause more serious concerns and damages to the engine. But as long as you're topping off that oil, a lot of the times that excessive oil consumption doesn't have any serious downsides or cause any serious harm to this engine. With all of those common problems out of the way, talking about this in summary and overall VQ37 VHR reliability, the VQ37 is a very reliable engine overall, especially some of the later engines. Again, I talked about the oil galley gasket issues, which predominantly affected those 2012 and older engines, and that's something that was an expensive repair bill, so kind of hurts the reliability a little bit for those older engines. But again, at this point, a lot of them that would likely experience that failure probably already have, so if you're in the market for one of those older models, see if there are any service records, see if that has been addressed, because that could be a good thing to have knocked out in the past from any previous owners and something that could save you in the future. Otherwise, catalytic converter failure can be somewhat common, but it's not really a serious issue or really anything too costly in the grand scheme. And then finally talked about the high oil consumption, which doesn't really have any design flaws or issues attributed to it. So nothing really against the VQ37 there. And ultimately, again, this is a very reliable engine. Outside of those few other problems, it's likely, especially as these engines continue aging and getting higher and higher in mileage, that occasional issues will pop up here and there. Of course, things like water pumps, failed coolant hoses, other oil leaks, coolant leaks, etc., become more common as the engine ages, but that can be said about any vehicle, any car, any internal combustion engine. So nothing to hold against the VQ37, just something to keep in mind that it is going to require a little extra TLC if you're looking for an older engine and something that might be 100,000 plus miles and 10 plus years old. Outside of that, use quality oils, keep up with maintenance, and do all of the basics, take care of the engine well, and the VQ37 can live a very reliable life to 200,000 plus miles. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.